Hi everyone, it's Dr. Cleopatra Gordon-Pusey with Life is Beautiful MD and Life is Beautiful Ministries. If it's your first time joining our channel, welcome and thank you for joining us. We are making these videos to inspire, to encourage, to lift you up, to let you know and be aware that God is alive and God is well and He's on His throne and He loves you and He cares about you, and we want you to just share this video with your friends, with your family, with your loved ones, so everyone can know Christ, come to know Christ, who to love and to know is life and life more abundantly. So I encourage you to share it with your friends, with your family, with your co-workers, so we could just spread the love of God throughout the entire world. It's a lot of times going on now. We're fighting the COVID war. We're literally fighting. War is going on overseas, all over the globe, and there's daily fight that people go through every day with struggles. So I'm encouraging you to share this video with your friends, with your family. Blessed to be a blessing. Thanks for joining us. We're gonna sing some songs. We're gonna continue to talk about faith, all about faith, part four. And I pray that this may just bless you and may God receive all the glory. We're gonna sing You Deserve the Glory, because all the glory and honor goes to God. We're just gonna start with that song and we're gonna go from there. And we're just gonna open up in prayer. Father God, we just thank you for being such an awesome God. We thank you for being such a wonderful God. You're the great I Am, you're the King of Kings, you're the Lord of Lords, you're the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah. There is none like unto you, God. From the rising of the sun to the going of the same, you are God and you're worthy. We thank you for allowing us to see this day. We thank you for allowing us to meet back in this session, in this way, Father. You said where two or three are gathered in your name, you are in our midst. So we pray that everything that is said and done here today, all the glory may go to you and your people may be blessed. Cover us individually, O God. Cover us collectively. May we just continue to walk in your way, walk in your light, and do your will. I pray that you may cause us to have a productive week. I pray that we may just continue to keep our eyes, our minds, and our thoughts on you, because you are the only one that can help us on this earth. I pray that you may help us to continue to follow your basic instruction before leaving earth. That's the B-I-B-L-E. That when all on this earth is past, what we do for you will last and we will make it into your heaven. I pray you may just forgive us of our sins, God, that all that was said to you may not come up to you void. Cover us individually, cover us collectively. Bless us, keep us, guide us, protect us. We just thank you for everything you've done, everything you're doing, and everything you're going to do. In your son's precious name, Jesus, we pray. Amen. 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 Let's go.
Your plans, that's just the way it is.
Yes, everyone, it's Dr. Cleopatra Gordon-Pusey with Life is Beautiful MD and Life is Beautiful Ministries. We're going to continue part four of All About Faith. We are reading from the book of Hebrews, from the basic instructions before leaving earth. Hebrews 11, verse 30, all the way to 39. It says, by faith, the wall of Jericho fell down after they were encircled for 7 days. By faith, the harlot Rahab did not perish with those who did not believe when she received the spies with peace. And what more shall I say? For the time would fall me to tell of Gideon and Barak and Samson and Jephthah, also of David and Samuel and the prophets, who through faith subdued kingdoms, worked righteousness, obtained promises, stop the mouths of lion, quench the violence of fire, escape the edge of the sword, out of weakness were made strong, became valiant in battle, and turned to fight the armies of the aliens. Women received their dead raised to life again. Others were tortured, not accepting deliverance, that they might obtain trial of mockings and scourgings environment. Women received their dead raised to life again. Others were tortured, not accepting deliverance, that they might obtain a better resurrection. Still others at trials of mockings and scourgings, yes, and of chains and imprisonment. They were stoned, they were sawn in two, they were tempted, were slain with the sword. They were delivered out of sheepskins and goatskins, being destitute, afflicted, tormented, of whom the world was not worthy. They wandered in the deserts and in the mountains, and in the dens and caves of the earth. And all these, having obtained a good testimony, through faith did not receive the promise. God having provided something better for us, that they should not be made perfect apart from us. We started in Hebrews 11, and we're ending at verse 39. This is part 4, and it says, without faith, it's impossible to please God. Jesus said we should have faith like a mustard seed. In the Bible here, it talks about David, it talks about Samuel, it talks about Gideon, it talks about Samson. You remember Samson? He was the Nazarene that was born, and when he was born, God told his mother not to shave his head, not to cut his hair, and his strength was in his hair. And we have to be careful about the people that we hang around with. Sometimes some crowds are not the best for us. So Samson, he had a significant other. Her name was Delilah, and he spent a lot of time with her, but she wanted to get money if she found out what his strength was, Samson's strength. Because Samson, you know, he was very strong, and he was like, he was a warrior, and he killed a lot of people, and they wanted to know how come he was so strong. So every time he was with his friend Delilah, the young lady, she used to, you know, seduce him and ask him, you know, why are you so strong? Finally, Samson trusted her enough, told her his secret, that the strength was in his hair. And while he slept, she cut his hair, and he lost all his strength, and he was taken over and taken to prison. And while the kings were going along their way, one day they decided they wanted to, you know, make a mockery of him, and they took him in this building, and they gorged out his eyes. He was blind, he couldn't see, but he asked this little young man to lead him to the pillars that held up the building. And Samson went there, and while he was there, he prayed, and he asked God to give him strength, and God gave him strength. His hair grew back, and Samson killed more in his death than he did in life, because he pushed the pillars apart, and the entire building came crumbling down, and everyone that was within the building, they died. And that was just faith. So we have to have faith. Look at Moses, remember him? Remember we spoke about him in a basket, how the Pharaoh's daughter found him, adopted him, and then when he killed someone in Egypt, he left and he fled, and he was 40 years in the wilderness tending to sheep. He found wives, he married them, but God built him up. Because as we know, sheep are not the easiest animals to tend for. But God built up Moses, raised him up, had him to be a shepherd, taking care of sheep, because God knew that Moses was going to be the leader of those Israelites and leading them out of Israel to the promised land. And even though Moses did not make it to the promised land, he took them across the Red Sea, he took them in the desert, and he took care of them while they were there. And they gave poor Moses so much problem, so much trouble. Moses did not make it to the promised land. We have to be careful about who we cause to put us into conflict, to bait us into conflict, because we follow this world, the things of this world, the people of this world. We may not make it to the promised land. We cannot rend evil for evil, but we have to rend good for evil. When someone does something bad to us, we can't, you know, do something back to them. Jesus came on this earth, and he, you know, they were saying an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth, but Jesus said if someone does something to you, we should turn the other cheek. You know, we have to have faith, and only faith can give you the chance to do something like this. Only faith can give you the opportunity to know that when someone does something wrong to you, you just have to be like Jesus when he was on the cross, and he said, God, forgive them, because they know not what they have done. We have to do the same thing. It was faith with me. I told you, $500, 2 white coats, my clothes and some linen, went to a faraway country, Dominica, to become a physician. God showed me the house that I was going to live in. I lived in that house for 1 year, and after everything came around, you know, faith again, I moved out that little tiny apartment, moved into town into a bigger apartment for myself, 3 bedrooms and living room, dining room, a front veranda, a back veranda. If anyone doesn't know what a veranda is, it's like a porch, the front porch or the back porch, or what others of us would call the balcony, front balcony, back balcony. And I prayed for God to, I needed my husband. I was gonna be on the island for 18 months and I just could not do it by myself. So second semester after December, I went back in January and I was not doing well because I was just missing my husband and I just wanted to go home. So I was taking care of everybody else, helping everybody else with their work, but I was not doing my own work. I was literally failing out of medical school because I said I was gonna leave. But through faith, I asked God, you know, I kept praying that let my husband see that he needs to come to Dominica. And I prayed and I prayed and I prayed. And when February 14 was coming around for Valentine's Day, I said, I'm going to buy a ticket for my husband. And I went to the agency, travel agency, to buy the ticket for my husband. And they told me it was $500. And I said, I will come back. The lady said the price may go up. I said, no, I'll come back, because still $500 was too much for me to pay for a ticket at that time. The next day I went back. She said, oh, good for you. The ticket went down to $400. I still said that was too high. I'll come back the next day. The lady said it might go back up again. I said, I'll take my chances. That's faith again, because I knew what I had to pay for that ticket. And I was waiting for the price to get to that place, even though I had a deadline because I wanted my husband to get to Dominica before February 14th. When I went back the next day, she told me the ticket came down to $375. I said, okay, I'll buy the ticket now. I bought the ticket. I called my husband. I told him, giving him a surprise. And we literally got into a little argument about that. He said, I don't have any time to come to Dominica. You just came to the United States. I took the time and I spent with you. My boss is not going to give me any more time off to come to Dominica for Valentine's Day. I said, just please ask him. He said, why did you buy the ticket? You wasted your money. I said, no, please ask him. And he went back and he asked his boss. The next day he came back. He told me his boss gave him like 2 weeks that he could come to Dominica and spend the time with me. When he was coming to Dominica, it's so funny, it was an American Airlines, you know, ticket for the plane. And when he was coming to Dominica, there was a strike. So they had to stop off in Puerto Rico. They put him in a Ritz-Carlton hotel because the flight, you know, went from United States to Puerto Rico. So they stopped there. There was no more flights going to Dominica because it was a strike. They put him up in a hotel. He stayed in the hotel and ended up coming to Dominica like a day later. But I essentially paid almost zero for the ticket because they reimbursed him the money for the ticket because of the inconvenience. And he came to Dominica. And I had already prayed. I went to Bible study when I was in Ross University School of Medicine. I went to Bible study every Wednesday and I went to church every Sunday and I never missed a day. And when my friends were inside, they were studying for school and they were there, they used to ask me, Cleopatra, why are you going to spend 2 to 3 hours and go to church? I said, no, I'm going to go to church because if I put God first, I know he's going to add everything else onto me. So they would ask me, Cleopatra, why are you going to church 2 to 3 hours on a Sunday? We have an exam coming up tomorrow. I just knew that if I put God first, everything else was going to be added onto me. And I wasn't doing that because I wasn't doing tit for tat. Oh, if I go to church, God's going to help me with the exam. God is, I said last week, if we don't praise him, the rocks are going to cry out in our stead. He made us, and the least we could do is to give him praise and take, you know, a few hours. We're supposed to be praising him and worshiping him every day. But on the weekends, we have to take, you know, a day and just give him more than what we gave him during the week. I went to Bible study. I went to church that Sunday. I was part of the praise and worship team we led. And that Wednesday, you know, we went to Bible study, and they asked if anyone has any requests, any prayer requests. And they said spoken or unspoken. So I stood up and I said, please, I'm asking you all to pray for my husband. I bought him a ticket to come to Dominica. I need him to see that when he gets here, he needs to stay here because I don't think I could do this journey without him. And this young man, that it's so funny, he only came to Ross University for one semester and then he decided to leave. But if he didn't come to Dominica for anything else, I know he came to pray so my husband could come to Dominica. that young man and I put my hand up and said, I'm praying for my husband to come here and to be here and stay with me so I can finish this, because I can't do this on my own without him. It's too much. We had just gotten married like 1 month, and we got married like August. We got married July, and I left for school August. I spent 4 months alone, crying every day, spent all my money on the phone. And then now here I am back to the same thing again, and I just couldn't do it. So the young man prayed, and he asked God to, you know, the prayer was so awesome. And after he said amen, and I said amen, I knew it was in front of the entire Ross Christian Fellowship, you know, it was in front of the whole Ross Christian Fellowship that we had that Wednesday. And I knew without a shadow of a doubt, the way he had prayed a prayer, I knew God heard, and he was gonna change the situation around. Ramo came to Dominica, and when he came to Dominica, I said, God, if he gets here, I am not going to ask him. I am not going to ask him to stay. I need you to show him that he needs to stay. And when Ramo came to Dominica, the second night, we were sitting on the balcony, looking at the stars, listening to the ocean. And he said to me, when do you want me to come back? I said, don't even leave. But he came with two suitcases. He left everything in Dominica. After 2 weeks, he went back to America. He packed up everything we had, packed up all our wedding gifts, everything. He quit his job and came to Dominica with me. I'm getting goosebumps as I speak to you right now. He left, and that's some faith. He quit his job. He was a supervisor, $60,000 a year he was making, and that was in 1998. And he quit his job, and he came to Dominica with me and spent 18 months. We traveled to a lot of little islands all around, and that was faith. He stepped out on faith. He didn't have any job. He was volunteering and helping the young people to pass their GED, but God blessed him, and he found a job in a bookstore, and that's where he worked for the next almost year and a half, and God just blessed us. It was almost like how Joseph, you know, went to Egypt, and he, you know, it looked like things weren't going his way, and things just turned around. So Bramwell became the bookstore manager, and by the time we finished the 18 months there, I became the first student of color president. So it was Mr. Bookstore Manager and Madame President, and it was all on faith. And I just give God the glory and honor for sending a best friend, an awesome friend like that, to be there by my side to help me through that entire 18 months on that island. And here we are together, going strong. God be praised. So without faith, it's impossible to please God. Whatever it is that you're going through, sometimes you have to take a leap of faith. I took a leap of faith. I went to Dominica to pursue my career, my goal to become a physician. My husband took a leap of faith, loved me enough, believed in me enough to quit his job and came to Dominica with me. And after a year and a half on that island, we came back to America. Lots of bumps and humps in the way, but here we are, 29 years being best friends, almost 24 years of married, husband and wife, and our three children, and her life is beautiful, and we're going on strong. Don't be afraid to take a leap of faith, because without faith, it's impossible to please God. I have so many more stories in my life and in his life that how God has brought us and how we have stepped out on faith and have seen the faithfulness and the goodness of God. So just continue to keep on keeping on. Don't be afraid. Trust in God with all your heart. Lean not onto your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge God, and he will direct your path. So we just thank you for listening. Continue to walk on faith. Allow God to come into your life. Allow him to go before you, spread the pathway, and whatever path he spread, that's where to follow. Don't follow your friends. Don't follow everything and everyone you hear. You have to pray to God, listen to him, and he will carve a path for you. And the path that he carved, you follow it. You have to do your part, and God will do his. He who began a good work in you is faithful to complete it. So I pray that this word may bless you. I pray that God may strengthen your faith. And if you don't have faith, I pray that you may ask him to teach you and show you little by little, baby steps. You have to crawl before you can walk, and you have to walk before you can run. But I know with God, all things are possible. So keep, you know, the faith, keep strong, be blessed, be covered. We love you with the love of the Lord. And this is Dr. Cleopatra Gordon-Pusey with Life is Beautiful MD and Life is Beautiful Ministries. Keep your faith, Keep strong. Don't let nothing stop you. Don't let anything bring you down. Don't let anyone bring you down. Because the Father up above, He loves you and He cares about you. And we love you and we care about you. If you need anything, just email us or just Google me, Dr. Cleopatra Gordon-Pusey, MD. You could email us at lifeisbeautifulmd@gmail.com. lifeisbeautifulmd@gmail.com. Be blessed. Be safe until we meet again. May the grace of Christ, our Savior and our Father, the love of God, the full fellowship of the Holy Spirit, rest, remain, and abide with us until Jesus come. Amen. 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 Take care. Bye-bye.
Who taught the sun where to stand in the morning? Who told the ocean you can only come this far? And who told the moon
so free, and I know.
That's just the way it is. You're not a God created by human hands. You're not a God dependent on any mortal man. You're not a God in need of anything we can give by your plan. That's just the way it is. You're God alone from before time began. You are on your throne. You are God alone. And right now, in the good times and bad, you are on your throne. You are God.
How's the year been?
Excellent.
Excellent? What's your wish?
Health. Wealth. Travel.
What advice would you give to anyone?
Stay focused on your goals and your dreams.
Yeah?
Yeah, God and family first.
What was that, sir?
God and family first.